No, the House of Stone was initiated by Gilda Boyardi of Interni, and she asked me, or rather she ordered me, to come up with a design for the Salon de Mobile this year. The most important thing for me when you're building is to try and create something which has atmosphere, something that's comfortable to be in, but in a way makes you feel different. I was shown this space, the Cortile 700, and you know, you always react to a site as an architect, and so I thought it'd be very, very nice to do something which was also enclosed but open to the sky. And I suppose using stone, it's such an elemental, powerful material. It's extraordinary how just a few blocks of stone can change your emotion once you step into it. The house runs east-west, and we wanted to use the existing path, so it's like a pavilion or a hut on a route somewhere. It's quite difficult to, I mean, it looks house-like, but it's quite ambiguous. You don't know really when you step into it. It could be a church, could be some other kind of earlier sacred place. And it reminds me a little bit of very small stone buildings we have in Scotland or Ireland, which are made of stone, the walls and the roof, all of the same stone. I mean, the big difference here is that it's a 21st century almost conceit, because we make the structure out of steel, so we can cantilever the roof like this and have this uninterrupted cut, which you couldn't do in the 7th century or the 6th century. The 21st century benefit now is that it's, it's used from waste material. So it's all very small pieces of offcuts, which normally would be thrown away and glued together. So it's totally ecological, and it also allows architects to develop their own individual patterns. So in a way, every panel is unique in some way.
Well, how did I get in touch with John? It's a funny story, a long story that I'll try to make short. But I happened to be having dinner with Gilda Boyardi some months ago, and we were discussing about several things. And I ended up telling Gilda about the project that I was working on, which was this new product in stone, all coming from recycled stone, so the waste and the scrap that otherwise we would have thrown away. And Gilda got very excited about it, and she said, "Gabriel, I think it's a great chance to show it at the Salone. We're doing an event which is going to be something nice, because we have several pretty important names in architecture. And so it would be great to combine you with some of these names. It's important to understand why I decided to choose John." And I actually fought to have John, because since the late 80s, late 80s, I was in Hong Kong at the airport waiting my flight to come back to Europe. And I was waiting inside the lounge of Cathay Pacific, and I was literally amazed by the beauty and the attention to details of this lounge. But it was just a lounge, I mean, but it was done in such a perfect way. So without even knowing who was the architect, at that time I thought it was probably a Chinese architect. I started to take pictures all over, all around, to the details, to the staircase, the gap that he left, to the light, how he was playing with the light. And so I came back with this bunch of pictures, and talking to a friend of mine a few days later, he said, "Gabriel, I mean, this is a pretty famous job, and John Pozon did it." So that was my first contact with John Pozon. And so when Gilda showed me the list, I said, "I've no doubt, Gilda, I'd like to do this with John." So John was mine, theoretically. I was a little bit scared, because this is a little bit a melting pot of material, and knowing the purism of John's architecture, I was afraid he was not going to like the product, therefore to decline the invitation. But luckily, he liked it. So we ended up starting to work together very hard because we've been working for 5 months, our team and his team, consistently, and this is the result.
What struck me about the collaboration with Salvatore wasn't really unexpected. It was just that it's an Italian approach that he was prepared to kind of jump in, and he must have had some kind of instinct, and then he made it happen. I think perhaps another European way would be to consider it for a long time, weigh up the pros and cons, and then carry it out. But what's very nice for me was we were moving at speed, and